Hi everyone, in this video I will demonstrate how to use Lingo to solve a linear programming model. The textbook describes several ways to solve a linear programming model. In chapter 2 and chapter 3, the book explains how to solve the model using the graphical solution approach. Basically, we graph the lines for all constraints, then determine the feasible region based on these constraints. After that, we graph the objective function line and find the optimal solution based on the objective function. This is a traditional way to solve a LP model with two variables and is introduced in most books of optimization. This method uses graphs, so it provides us with visual process and solutions, which are easier to understand. However, this method only works with two decision variables and requires skills in graphing lines. We do not cover this method in this course, but I strongly suggest reviewing the example and practice with it, since it will help you understand better the linear programming method and how to solve a linear programming model. A more effective way is to use optimization software, since it can handle more complex models and can find the solution very quickly. Most optimization software applications use a simplex algorithm to find the optimal solution. The textbook demonstrates how to solve a linear programming model using Excel Solver or Lingo. My preference is Lingo, since this software is easy to use and widely used by the academia and the industry. It can handle all models from simple to complex. It is expensive, but it has a free edition for students. On the other hand, Excel Solver is also easy to use, but requires some organizing of the variables and data in the spreadsheet. Note that we need to use add-in in Excel to have the solver features. In addition, as the model gets more complex, it will be harder to set up the model in Excel Solver. In this video, I will demonstrate on how to use Lingo to solve a linear programming model. If you want to try Excel Solver, you can follow the demonstration in the book. Note that Lingo has both Windows and Mac versions, which are identical. The student edition is free, but has some limit on the number of variables and constraints. I think it should be enough for us in this course. If you want the full version, you can request it for the educational or research purpose only. I posted the detailed instructions on Canvas. This is Lingo interface. The advantage of Lingo is that we can use the model we developed before in the standard form and just copy and paste it to Lingo. With some very minor changes, we should have the model ready to run. So let's go back to our model in Word file. First, I copy and paste the objective function to Lingo. Now, Lingo requires the equal sign, so I add equal sign after max. In addition, for multiplication, we need to use the asterisk. At the end of this line, we add a semicolon. So the correct syntax for Lingo is max equal 10 times s plus 9 times d semicolon. For constraints, Lingo does not require to put subject to. So we just copy and paste all constraint expressions to Lingo. The only thing we need to change is to add the asterisk for multiplication and add a semicolon at the end of each line. The less than or equal sign will work for Lingo. The fraction also works for Lingo. So we make these changes and we have our Lingo model ready. At the end, we add end in the last line to tell Lingo that this is the end of the model. This syntax is required by Lingo. Note that Lingo is a product of Lingo. Lingo has a little different requirements, such as we have to add subject to the model, and we do not have to use asterisks. Just keep that in mind. That is how to convert our linear programming model in a standard form to Lingo model. The last constraint, S and D must be non-negative, will be selected in the options window. Before we solve the model, we need to make some option selections. On the menu bar, select Solve and click Options. That will open the Lingo options window. We will focus on General Solver tab. In the D1 Computations group, we make sure that we select prices and ranges. This is to make sure we will have ranges in the solution. We also need to make sure the box variables assumed non-negative is checked. This is to ensure that the decision variables are non-negative. So we do not actually have to have that constraint in the model and just need to check this box. And select OK, or we can select Solve to solve the model. We can also select Solver on the menu bar and select Solve, or just click the Solve button on the toolbar to solve the model. You see that the software finds the solution almost instantly because this is a very small model. If there are any formulation errors during the compilation phase, Lingo will give us an error message. The Lingo Solver status window shows us the status of the solution. So we have two variables and five constraints. Note that the first row of these constraints actually refers to the objective function. The non-zeros box shows the total non-zero coefficients in the model. In this case, we have 10 coefficients, 2 for the objective function and 8 for the constraints. This window also indicates that we have a linear programming model, or LP. The optimal objective value is 7668. The iterations field displays the number of iterations completed thus far by Lingo Solver. In this case, we have 2 iterations. This is a Lingo solution report, which matches the solution in the textbook. I will cover the results interpretation and sensitivity analysis in another video. That is how to solve a linear programming model using Lingo. Thank you, and bye now.